On April 1st of this year, U.S. 10-year Treasury yields were 1.75%. Since that time, they've pretty much headed straight south, mostly on economic concerns surrounding the pandemic, to a current level around 1.3%. Now, interestingly, over the last 35 years, the slope of decline in the 10-year yield has been remarkably consistent. After a volatile early 1980s, in 1987, the 10-year was near 10%, and it began its gradual decline to a low near 0.5% in July of 2020. Now, historically, 10-year yields have been a source of macroeconomic information. High yields may indicate inflation or an inflationary environment based on a booming economy, but very low yields can be an indication of economic distress, disinflation, or disinflationary pressures. And traditionally, 10-year yields lower than 2-year yields, an inverted curve, can be an indication of an impending recession. Now, over the last few years, things have changed. Fed actions to manually force rates lower may have reduced the predictive power of the 10-year yield. The Fed has a number of tools it can use to do this, but as we discussed recently, the one that I've been looking at mostly over the last 2 years and has been featured most prominently is QE, or quantitative easing, simply purchasing longer-term treasuries and other assets. Now, during the Jackson Hole Summit, Federal Reserve Chairman Powell indicated the possibility of tapering these purchases later this year. A trader now has to ask themselves, is a 1.3% 10-year yield indicative of a coming storm, or is it merely a reflection of the Fed's desire to keep rates low? Now, as I touched on in the very first video in this series, one of the elements of interest rate trading that's so interesting to me is that rates have the potential to impact the price of just about any other asset price, including equities. Now, if a trader believes that a coming Fed taper could force rates higher and potentially cause stock market stress, as an example, they could buy the CME micro treasury yield contract as a directional trade or as a hedge against a long stock position at the current level of 1.3 and target the early summer level of 1.5. This trade could make $10 per basis point or $200 per contract. Now, if a trader believes this multi-decade decline in rates will continue in the short term, they could sell the micro 10-year yield contract at that same 1.3 level and target the early 2021 lows of 1.18. This trade could make 12 basis points or $120 per contract.